Hello and welcome once again. I'm Scott Levin to another edition of Get to Know. We have a really special guest today. This is a person who has accomplished so much for Western New York that he was just named in the top 10 of Buffalo Business First Power 250. I want to introduce you all to Dr. Satish Tripathi. He is the big cheese over at UB. He has been there since 2004, and he has been the president, CEO, principal, whatever you want to call him, since 2011. Dr. Tripathi, thank you for joining us today. We appreciate your time, sir.
Thank you, Scott. Glad to be here with you.
Thank you so much. First of all, congratulations on being named to Buffalo Business First, Power 250. Congratulations. That is quite an honor. What was your reaction when you heard you were in the top 10?
You know, it's good to be in a good company. I've been in that group for a while, and it's always good to see that. But really, I mean, I'm not expecting to be in top 10, and it wasn't something that I worked for, but it's really great to be in that group.
It really is, and it is quite a powerful group in Western New York. Let's let the folks get to know you a little bit better. They know you now as the gentleman who runs UB, has been very successful at growing the campus with buildings and with students and with teachers. Let's go all the way back to your childhood. Tell everyone where you were born, where you grew up, and how you grew up.
Well, Scott, I really grew up in a very, very small village in India. In northern India, in a family of teachers. My great-grandfather had a school. They taught Sanskrit in the village. My grandfather had taught in the same school. And my father was a principal. So, you know, the title you gave me is my father's title. He was the principal. So I grew up in this very small village with almost no facilities. My primary school was 2 miles away that I used to walk, and I went to third grade straight, and sort of spent the first 13 years of my life in the village, going to the 10th grade, and the village, as I said, was divided into three sort of groups, three hamlets. In my part of the hamlet, there were about 20 houses, and we knew each other very well. There was farming done in the village as well. So I had the pleasure of working on the farm, not really directly working, but I knew what's going on. Mm-hmm. And really studying. My mother was really the one that distilled in me the love for mathematics. So really, although she was educated only up to sixth grade, but she really taught me mathematics in junior high and beyond. She knew math more than she had studied, actually. So my love for math actually grew up in my village with my mother. And I'm one of the seven siblings.
Wow.
I'm number two. My sister, older sister, who always told me what I need to do.
Very good. So let me ask you, you grew up in this very small village. What did you aspire? What did you want to be? You knew you were good at computer sciences and mathematics. What was your dream to become one day?
Those days, there was no computer science. I wanted to be a math and science teacher. My real love was in math and science, and I wanted to teach. Of course, I'd seen teaching up to high school and all that, so that's what I wanted to teach in math and sciences high school. That was my goal.
Well, you have certainly surpassed that. Let me read to you. You are now known as an internationally recognized as an accomplished researcher and transformative higher educational leader. That is quite an introduction. You have really, really, made your way in the educational business. When you left India, that small village, where did you go to college? Tell everyone where you went to college.
When I finished my 10th grade, there's a board exam, the whole province, and I did really well. And then actually to study science, I had to go to the district headquarters and for 11th and 12th grade. And I stayed in a boarding house, and studied there. I was 13, I left my home and studied up to grade 12th there. And then I went to this very good university, Banaras Hindu University, that's about 100 miles from my village. And again, I was in the dorm there for 4 years. Mm-hmm. I studied there mathematics, physics, and statistics. Those were the areas that I really concentrated on.
And I know you have three master's degrees, correct?
I know. I can't figure out what to do.
You know, most people are lucky if they have one master's degree. You have three, my friend. In California, you quadrupled. That is huge. The number of students at the University of California, Riverside, from unranked to now in the upper half of U.S. News and World Report, which I know very well because my daughter was a freshman this year. So I know that that is an important thing. Tell me, you know, when you landed here in Buffalo, you had different jobs here in the States. You landed here in 2004. What was your thoughts? You had been raised in India, you had lived in California, and you end up in Buffalo. What were your thoughts when you got to Buffalo?
So let me go a little bit back. So I actually came to Canada, did my PhD at the University of Toronto. And so I knew Buffalo. I was very close to Buffalo at that time. And then I went to University of Maryland College Park for many years. For almost 19 years, I was faculty member, professor, department head, and so on. And then, as you said, I went to California as a dean. So when I came to Buffalo, UB has been a great university. In my field in computer science, actually, it is one of the early starters. Actually, if you look at the departments that were formed, computer science is a new field. Most of the early departments were established in the late 60s. And UB has been one of the pioneers in there. So I knew about certain fields here. It is an AAU university. This is the part of the 62 public and private top universities in the country. So you know, SUNY Buffalo or UB wasn't new to me in terms of as an institution. So the opportunity came for me to come here as a provost. And I would say, as we talked about earlier, I was lucky to be selected. It's a great place. And I came, and John Simpson was president here, President Simpson, who had come from California as well. And you know, what we both saw was really a great potential to really take UB to the next stage. Not that it wasn't at the high stage to begin with. As I said, it was really in the top public and private research universities in the country. Great faculty, great city. I mean, this is really a place to live. Now I can tell everybody that this is really a place where people welcome you, they're supportive of you. And so really coming here was for me to try to make an impact in higher education, take the university in really directions that it can improve the impact in the Western New York, in the nation, around the world.
And I know you have kind of coined the phrase a living learning environment. You really believe in that, correct?
That's definitely true. I mean, this is really, this is how we all learn, right? I mean, you know, it's not just what we learn in the classroom. It is actually that we need to live that and learn. It is also, I've said many times, that you can't be a great university if you're not in a great city. So we are really joined together. The better the city does, the better the university does, and vice versa.
Now, I want folks to get to know you a little bit better, of course. You are the first international-born president at UB, and you graduated, of course, in the top 10 of your class. So we know that you have the chops that it takes to be in your position. What is the biggest challenge for Dr. Satish Tripathi right now? I mean, you've brought on a bunch of new buildings. You've had a huge era of growth. What is next for you to accomplish on campus?
So there are two aspects here, Scott. One is, what is the greatest challenge now? And we are going through a pandemic. The greatest challenge is really health and safety of our student, faculty, staff here. And the challenge, of course, for us is to make sure that the community is also secure and we really provide the expertise that we have. What we are pushing towards really is to be top 25 public university in the country. This is not a challenge. This is something that we have defined and we want to achieve it. But this is not a slogan. This is really how we impact, mm-hmm. how we really change the way we think, change the way we treat people, we change the way we sort of take care of the patients, you know, all those things together. So this is something that we have positioned ourselves into. If you look at last few years, we practically have moved about 30 places in that direction. So really, I mean, and it's not all that I have done here. It's really, we have got great faculty, great staff and students here, and it's their achievement. And not to forget the alumni. I mean, think about it. I tell my alumni, the better you do, the better I really do, because that's how I'll be known, you know.
That is the sign of a very good leader, Dr. Tripathi. Very well said. Tell me a little bit about your family. I think you celebrated 50 years of marriage to your wife. You have a bunch of kids. Tell everyone about your family.
Yeah, so we were actually married when we were teenagers. It was an arranged marriage.
Right.
And not
unusual in India.
It wasn't unusual at that time, but things have changed since then.
Yes, they have a little bit.
So we have two sons. One was born in Canada when I was a graduate student in Toronto. And the other one was born in Washington, D.C. area when we were living in Maryland. As I told you, I'm a fourth generation teacher. My older son went to Stanford. Then he did PhD at Kellogg. And he actually was faculty member at Emory. So I told my father that I have done my job. The business continues. However, a few years ago, he left Emory and he works for Amazon. He's into AI and machine learning and all the marketing, all that kind of thing. My second son went to Berkeley. He also did MBA at Kellogg. He went to Kellogg for MBA. And he also worked for Amazon. So they both live in Seattle. And they both married. My older son has two children, so we haven't been able to visit our grandchildren for more than a year now.
You will soon, though. Soon you'll be able to.
Exactly. My wife had a science degree in India. When she came, she did nursing in Canada, worked for about 2 years. But when our first son was born, she decided she wanted to spend more time, and which is good for me because as a new faculty member in Maryland, to get a tenure, I really had to work much harder, and she really supported me
a lot. Well, coming from India, let's talk a little bit about Buffalo. Do you enjoy, what's your favorite season in Buffalo? And I hear you like to travel. Where do you like to travel when you like to get away?
So I travel all around the world. I mean, I've got alumni everywhere. So we have been to most of the countries, at least in Asia and many in Europe. I really love to go to Seattle and surrounding areas, beautiful places there that we can get to park and so on. We love spring, but it's too short here.
Yes, it is.
You know, when we lived in Washington, D.C. area, it was really it was short because the summer came quickly. But I really like spring. I like winter, but not as long as it's here. It's a little bit longer here.
Right. And let me ask you, people want to get to know you. What are some of your, name a couple restaurants that you love to go to locally. I assume you live in the North Towns, maybe the South Towns?
Actually, I live in President's House in near the South Campus, about a mile from there. And, you know, we usually like to go to, I'm not going to give you a name, but we usually like to go to some Mexican or Italian restaurant. We are both vegetarian. My wife and I are vegetarian, so we go to Chinese, right. Mexican, Italian, wherever we can find some ethnic, and actually Mediterranean, and there's some good vegetarian dishes there that we find and we enjoy that. We also go to some Indian places sometimes, although we can cook that.
But I'm sure your wife is a better cook than some of the restaurants, I would think, right?
No, but we can still go. We can take people there.
There you go. That's right. You don't have to do the dishes.
Exactly. All right.
I know you're busy. Just a couple more questions, Dr. Tripathi. You speak three languages. Tell the folks at home what languages you speak.
So of course, I speak Hindi, as that was first language. I speak English, of course, a little bit. And I actually speak a dialect that was spoken in my village, that's Audhi, but I also understand a couple of other Indian languages. I speak some, I understand some Bangla language and also some Punjabi.
Wow.
And, but you know, in India, there are a lot of languages and they're totally different.
Dialects, right.
Yeah, actually not dialects, Steve. I mean, there are written and spoken languages and they're totally different from each other.
Wow, okay, two final questions. What do you miss most about India?
you know, I miss my relatives and people, but I really visit there often. As you know, when I get time, I try to go for a few days, 3-4 days, 5 days, a couple mm-hmm. of times a year, meet my folks there. So I miss people actually. And I've been to multiple places, and it's not the place, but the people that I miss most.
And my final question, what do you love about Buffalo?
Well, I really love people. I mean, they have been very kind to us, Steve. I mean, really, people sort of embracing what we do, people really supporting us in terms of our university, our mission, and really very easy town to sort of go around and do things. You know, having lived in DC area, having lived in Los Angeles area, this is really piece of cake, really great place to visit people here, to go around, to get to the airport in 10 minutes. Everything is nice.
It really is. And what is nice is that we have such a wonderful guy like you running the largest university here in Western New York. Dr. Satish Tripathi, thank you so much. You've been here for 10 years. Hopefully you get another good 10 years in you. And you've done a tremendous amount of work in the campuses, all three of the campuses here in Western New York. And we thank you for joining us today for Get to Know, sir.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you so much.
I appreciate your time.